hôm nay sẽ có sự tham dự của hai trường là trường Đại học Tây Sydney, Western Sydney University ở thành phố Sydney của tiểu bang New South Wales. Đại diện trao đổi với chúng ta ngày hôm nay sẽ là cô Ginny. Thì cô Ginny là quản lý tuyển sinh các cái chương trình quốc tế. Và đại diện đến thứ hai đó là cô Mindy đến từ trường Đại học Nam Úc, University of South Australia, thành phố Adelaide của tiểu bang Nam Úc. Thì trước tiên chúng ta sẽ dành vài phút để làm quen với hai cô nhé. Hi Ginny, could you please say hi to the student and briefly introduce about yourself?
Yeah, sure. Hi, everybody. My name is Janice. You can call me Jin. I am the International Regional Manager at Western Sydney University. So if you have any specific question after this, you can chat with me in the Q&A session. I'd like to thank you for joining in today, taking up your Saturday, precious Saturday time. So thanks for being here. Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much for your introduction, Jin. And hello, Mindy. The audience,
hi, everyone.
The audience are waiting to hear your voice. So could you say hi and briefly introduce about yourself?
Xin chào, everyone. Hi from Adelaide. I'm the coordinator for our health sciences programs. So hopefully everyone is ready to listen to Janice and myself about our programs, and Sam, welcome to any questions later. And hopefully you will enjoy our sessions today.
Thank you, Mindy. So now we are starting the information section today. So first, just let me briefly go through the content in Vietnamese, and then we will be back to your presentation. Okay. Trước tiên thì để các bạn tiện theo dõi chương trình ngày hôm nay thì chị xin điểm qua những cái nội dung chính cho các bạn ha. Thì ở phần đầu chương trình thì sẽ là phần trình bày của cô Ginny và cô Mindy về thông tin của hai trường. Thì hai cô sẽ lần lượt cung cấp cho chúng ta những thông tin về trường, về những xếp hạng cũng như những thành tích của trường, những lợi thế về cơ sở vật chất cũng như là các cái chương trình đào tạo của trường. Thì trong phần chia sẻ những cái ngành học của ngày hôm nay thì hai trường sẽ tập trung nói nhiều về những ngành liên quan đến khoa học sức khỏe là health science, điển hình là ngành y tá, và cơ hội việc làm của ngành này sau khi tốt nghiệp tại Úc. Những cái thông tin về học bổng thì cũng sẽ được hai cô chia sẻ trong cái phần trình bày của mình luôn. Tiếp nối cái phần thông tin của hai trường sẽ là thông tin về các cái phần hỗ trợ của du học xét sẽ dành cho các bạn du học sinh xuyên suốt trong thời gian các bạn học tập tại Úc. Phần cuối của chương trình sẽ dành thời gian cho một hỏi đáp. Thì trong suốt chương trình, nếu các bạn có bất kỳ những cái câu hỏi nào muốn hỏi trường cũng như là hỏi phía du học xét thì các bạn có thể nhắn tin ở một chat box bên phía tay phải màn hình của mình. Và hôm nay thì hai đại diện trường sẽ trao đổi với chúng ta hoàn toàn bằng tiếng Anh, cho nên là chị sẽ hỗ trợ trong việc là mình tóm tắt những cái ý chính cũng như dịch lại những cái thông tin quan trọng cho các bạn ở sau mỗi phần trình bày của trường ha. Thì đầu tiên chị sẽ mời cô Ginny sẽ chia sẻ cho chúng ta những thông tin về trường Western Sydney. Hi Ginny, you will start with the information from Western Sydney University first. So please feel free to share your presentation, play video as well, deliver information in English. So I will have to summarize and translate the main points as well in important information to student after you finish your presentation.
Yes, thank you so much, Hien. I've shared my screen just to confirm. Are you guys seeing this one screen for Western Sydney?
Yep, great.
Yeah, excellent. Great, great. Thanks for the introduction, Hien. So now the first part of this today's presentation we'll talk about Western Sydney University. Then after my part, Mindy will join in and she will talk about UniSA. Right. If I'm speaking a bit too fast or if you have any question while I'm presenting, you would like me to repeat or anything like that, feel free to drop your questions in the chat box or in the Q&A box below. So first of all, I'd like to just quickly touch on some of the key strengths and why Western Sydney University. First of all, we are currently the top 2% of university in the world with only 30 years of history. So with just a mere 30 years, we managed to climb our way up to become the top 2% in the world. That is something we take a lot of pride in for Western Sydney. And most importantly, Western Sydney University is actually the number one university in New South Wales for employer satisfaction. So what this means is our graduates have been rated the most satisfactory for all the employers in New South Wales. And nationally, in the entire Australia, we're ranked number two. The first university, number one university is actually Bond University, which is in Queensland. And this is a new achievement and announcement for the university. We are currently the third in the world for Times Higher Education Impact Ranking. So this is another achievement that we are also very proud of. Western Sydney University currently have a 5-star rating on QS Top Universities. Most importantly, we have an extensive professional accreditations and international recognition for our courses. So this allows our students to graduate with a marketable and highly demanded qualification. So basically what this means, it includes industry-specific accreditations from Australia's leading institutions. So you will get the accreditations based on the subjects that you've completed. We have a very practical approach with the curriculum that strongly combines work experience. So this is designed to be a springboard for the career success of our international students. Actually, not just international, so students as a whole. So from here, you will actually know many of our programs actually do have a strong internship and work integrated learning embedded into the course. Most of our postgraduate curriculums are actually developed together with industry partners. So that means most of our postgraduate programs come with a very strong focus on practical skills and critical thinking. Western Sydney University, as you can tell from our name itself, we are centered in our Western Sydney region in Australia, which is Australia's fastest growing economic region. One of our main campus and newest campus is actually located in Parramatta City itself, which is the second largest city outside of Sydney CBD. And it is also one of the fastest growing development cities in Australia. So students who are studying business and media marketing, you will have the choice to study in the main campus, which is in this Parramatta City, which is only 50 meters from the main train station. And you have access to all the retails, restaurants, shops, and most importantly, you get great opportunities to employment as well. We have a very competitive price range, which offers great value for money. So for Western Sydney University, our program ranges between $26,000 per year up to a maximum of $33,000 per year. And that is before scholarships. So which brings me to the last point. Western Sydney is actually quite generous with scholarship. We're offering up to a 25% international scholarships on top of the very competitive price. And we also have a 50% vice-chancellor scholarships for high-achieving students. I will have a section to talk specifically about scholarships later on. So at the moment, the university has about 47,000 students in total, which about 6,700 are international. That's about 15%. But what's great about Western Sydney is the diversity within our students. So if you look at it, 15%, 6,700 of these international students, they come from over 170 different countries. So with this kind of background, we're able to promote a very positive learning experience and provide a great diversified environment, especially to international students. And this also provides a great opportunities for you guys to be able to practice and learn and improve your English as well. So now I'll quickly touch on some opportunities within Western Sydney region so you guys understand where it is and what's happening within this area. So Western Sydney is actually the third largest economy in Australia. This is a very important point, which a lot of people actually don't know that. We come right after Sydney CBD, Melbourne second, and the third largest economy contribution in Australia is actually Western Sydney region. At the moment, on top of that, the government and private sector has invested an additional $12 billion into the region, focusing on infrastructure expansion. So if you're looking at this right now, it will show you a few big projects that is happening within Western Sydney that will benefit students and graduates who's around the area directly. So first of all, there's a light rail network, so what we call tram for people who's more used to the term. So like a tram network is actually starting, they started building from Parramatta City, and that's going to link up a few other cities within Western region. We have Western Sydney Airport also expected to open in the next few years as well. They have started to build that too. Badgerys Creek, and we have Sydney Science Park. Most importantly, Westmead Health Precinct. So Westmead Health Precinct, it's like a little area with all the health industry. You've got hospitals, childcare, nursing homes, all of these health-related businesses in one area. And Westmead Health Precinct is actually one of the biggest health precinct in Australia. Just this precinct alone, it generates over 50,000 employment within Westmead Health Precinct as well, only. And that's very, very close to our main campuses. So students who are studying nursing, health sciences, those kind of medicine type of program will get great internship, practical, clinical practice or jobs kind of opportunities within this area. Museum of Arts and Applied Science, WestConnect have started building. It's ongoing. It's actually Australia's biggest infrastructure project, also happening within Western Sydney. And lastly, tourism, of course, has increased by 40% since for Western Sydney. So this picture actually shows the growth within Western Sydney itself. A lot of big things happening. That means it's able to offer you as an international student great opportunities as well. At the moment, just Western Sydney region, there are over 200,000 new jobs just in Western Sydney itself. So these are the campuses within Western Sydney. We have 11 campuses in total, all across Western Sydney region. Next, I'm going to show a short clip of a video showcasing our campuses. Oops. One second. Okay. Thank you. to see. I think someone put a chat in. Oh, all good. Okay. Did you guys hear, was there the sound, and did you get to hear the sound of it?
Yeah,
the checking, technicals are good. Thank you, Ian. Great. Okay. I've also included some pictures for you guys to see some of our key campuses. So this is the Parramatta City campus, which is one of our latest and newest campus. And as you can see, it is a modern high-rise building, quite different from the other campus where it's kind of on the ground, big compound. Now this is a, our campuses takes up 12 stories of that building. It's very modern, very fancy. As a matter of fact, we actually share this building with PwC, which is one of the big four accounting firms. So our campus is from ground floor to level 12, and PwC takes on from level 13 and onwards. So we do share this campus with one of the big four accounting firms. So this campus is available to business students. So if you're interested in business, media, marketing, these areas, it's all in this campus. We have the Parramatta main campus as well that offers majority of the courses. And Campbelltown campus is mainly for nursing and medicine, health science, these type of courses. Quickly touch on, for Western Sydney, we have a Hawkesbury campus, which is considered to be in a regional area. So any student out there who want to take advantage of the regional scheme, where you want to get an additional year of post-study work visa to have 3 years instead of the standard 2 years, you can apply to our Hawkesbury campus, and upon graduating, you actually can benefit from that. However, we do have some limited courses in Hawkesbury, but nursing is definitely in there. So we do offer nursing courses in Hawkesbury, health sciences, science, and agriculture programs. Now I'm just going to quickly touch on what the university is doing, responding to COVID-19, how are we supporting international students and our students' study experience. So I'm touching on first promotion. So at the moment, all of our courses are being delivered online, even for the coming intake for July. Session 2 intake and quarter 3 intake for postgraduate programs, they will all be commencing online because campus are still not allowed to open, and that's across all universities here in Australia. So any of you guys who are currently now in Vietnam and interested to commence in July, you can commence with Western Sydney online in your own home country. Once the border open up and when you come back into Australia, then you can continue your course face-to-face. Now, because courses are delivering online at the moment, the university is offering a 10% fee reduction to all international students who choose to commence in this coming intake. So that would automatically apply to all students. On top of that, we are offering a reduced deposit for package students as well. Initially, the deposit is $5,000 if you're packaging with a diploma foundation or a bridging program, but now we are offering just $2,000 of deposit. So that's less than 50%. That's actually more than 50% reduced. Offshore student, if you choose to commence in this July online overseas, so in Vietnam, you actually can choose to start with a reduced study load. So generally students will start with 4 units if you're doing a bachelor, but you can actually choose to start with only 2 subjects instead of 4. So that means this will reduce your commencement fee by half the standard rate. So you're paying 50% less for your commencement fee. This is for offshore students specifically, yeah? Now, if you then start the course online offshore in Vietnam, and later on, let's just say, touch wood, you got a visa refusal, you will actually be entitled for a full refund. Even if you have started the course halfway through, you've studied, 6 weeks of the course while you're in Vietnam, and when the borders open, when you start applying for your visa and you got a refusal, even though you have studied half of the semester, you will still get the full refund from the university. And lastly, students are allowed to repeat for free. So if you started this course while it's online and you don't find it suitable to you, you just can't seem to get it, or you still can't pass the subjects, the university allows you to retake the subject at no cost. So you can retake that subject that you failed in the next semester or so. There's no additional cost. And most importantly, there won't be any academic penalty. So that means your failed subjects will not show on your transcript. But it comes with one condition. So you need to at least demonstrate that you have tried, you have put in effort to pass. So that includes actually submitting an assessment if you need to, or actually attending classes, or actually communicating with your unit coordinator. At least show that you have been trying, but you still failed. So if you have shown that and still not passed, then you definitely can benefit from this. Now, in terms of admission, we do have some temporary changes as well due to COVID. So first of all, we have extended the test validity, so the expiry date for an English test, to 3 years from the usual 2 years. So we've extended that. But this applies to the standard programs, all programs that has the standard IELTS 6.5 programs. So programs like nursing and medicine that requires a higher IELTS, unfortunately, it won't apply to this. We are also accepting other type of English evidence at the moment, because we do acknowledge a lot of test centers for PTE and IELTS are not open still. So we are accepting IELTS indicated score, TOEFL IBT Special Home Edition, and Duolingo as well. And again, similar to the above, this is available to only all programs with the standard 6.5 English level. We are also accepting predicted score at the moment. So if your final results or the national examination results are not releasing late and you want to commence the session before that, we are looking at just predicted score at the moment. Document verification, if you're finding it hard to actually get your document physically certified because you know, you have the restrictions going on, your agent's not opening office or anything like that, we currently also do accept just online screenshot transcript that's uncertified. However, the certified copy still must be submitted a week before intake starts. And lastly, we currently do consider issuing a conditional COE, but on a case-by-case basis. So it's not to all, it's just for a special case. So we can consider that. Now, for teaching, how are our classes being moved online at the moment? I think a lot of you, especially the offshore one, are quite interested about that. So first of all classes has now moved completely online, including lecture and tutorials. But most importantly, all of these classes will be recorded. So you don't need to attend those classes live. You can go back to do the revision recorded class at a later time. Because for example, the time difference, if the time starts here at 9 o'clock, it is 6 a.m. back in Vietnam. So you don't need to attend that live. You can definitely go back to the recorded session. Students still have access to a one-on-one consultation with your professor, lecturer, your unit coordinator. Again, it's just instead of doing it face-to-face, you'll just set an appointment, you meet with them through Zoom or virtual. So it is still available to all students. We're using Zoom and Blackboard Collaborator as a platform for this online delivery. Students will still be working in groups for some online assessment. So that is still there for some subjects that needs group assignment. You will still be working in groups done virtually. There are still assessment needed to be submitted and exams. However, all of these, again, exams are done online and also assessment just to be submitted online. We have moved most of the labs part through to virtual labs. However, we do acknowledge some subjects that are very, very strongly practical that it's impossible to move to online or virtual. Then we are postponing those subjects for students to take on later when things goes back to face-to-face. So you don't have to take those subjects in your first semester. And of course, with all of this, the school is providing extra support with online mentor sessions and online industry mentor seminars to students as well. Lastly, we've been reaching out to our students, trying to get some feedbacks and kind of see how they're going. We are very, very pleased to receive very positive response from our current students regarding to Western Sydney online teaching. So about the key courses. So from my understanding today, we're focusing on marketing, media, and nursing. So if any of you out there has any specific inquiries or different program we didn't touch on today, feel free to chat with us at the Q&A session in the end. So now I'm gonna talk marketing, which is part of our School of Business. So our School of Business will be delivering all the marketing programs, and we do have placement and community-based practical experience for marketing, but general as a whole School of Business, if you're looking at a Bachelor of Accounting, I'm not sure if any interested, but just a key point that Western Sydney is actually the only university that has a triple star accreditation for the Bachelor of Accounting program. So that shows a very strong accreditation for our courses. So if you're looking at marketing, there are three different programs you can consider. First, if you're looking at undergrad, you can do the Bachelor of Business, and then you can choose your specialization in marketing area. But the great part for our Bachelor of Business is you can choose up to two different specializations. So if you're interested in marketing, but you also may have some interest in a different area, or if you know there are some other industry that are booming at the moment that you would like to also have that skills and have that opportunities to explore your career in there, the Bachelor of Business is a great way to do that. So you study a Bachelor of Business and then you specialize in marketing, and you can choose any other areas that you like. For example, one of the ones that are growing at the moment is international business, sport management, and human resource management. So there's a very strong flexibility for you to kind of choose what else you want to add on besides marketing, or you can choose to just specialize in one marketing. So all of your subjects are a lot more focused in just marketing area. So Bachelor of Business offered in three different campuses, Bankstown, Campbelltown, and Parramatta City. We have this current July intake, or you can wait till next year for March intake. For postgraduate, then we have two different programs for students who are interested in marketing. You can do the MBA for 2 years and also choose your specialization in marketing. So as you can see, our MBA has a very strong options in terms of specializations. We have 14 different specializations, and most of them are actually in high demand at the moment. One of them is marketing. So you can do an MBA specializing in marketing. If you know for sure, I just want to do marketing, I'm not interested in any business area, you don't want to know any management area, then you can choose to do a Master of Marketing. You notice here there are three different duration. So the three different duration, 1 year, 1.5 year, 2 years, it depends on your background. So if you've completed a bachelor degree in marketing, or if you have work experience, so based on that, your duration can be lesser. Accreditation. So for marketing, we do have an accreditation for the Australian Marketing Institute. So if you choose a Bachelor of Business and you take the marketing specialization, you will graduate not only with our degree, but you will get the accreditation from AMI as well. And if you choose to do a double specialization for your bachelor, you take on a marketing, and let's just say you take on a property, or in HR, or in accounting or finance, then you get two different type of accreditation. You get an AMI in marketing and another different one that you choose to study. So this actually shows the level of accreditations we get. And these are all of our engagement network when it comes to work placement, internship opportunities. So we work closely with these brands over here. Quickly touch on the Center of Excellence at PwC. Western Sydney University has a very strong partnership with PwC. As you know, we actually share the same building as well. In 2019, PwC actually has took on 125 interns from Western Sydney alone. And out of these 125, 50% are actually international students, and another 50% are domestic. So the chances for our international students who are studying in our School of Business has a strong opportunity to get a really good internship and work placement. And this is just one of the example. We work with a lot of other big organizations as well when it comes to internship placement and industry connection. Nursing, okay. So we, our nursing degree are professionally accredited, of course, by APRA. So students who graduate from our program will be able to register to be a registered nurse here. We're ranked number one nursing school in Australia by the Center for World University Ranking and top 100 in the world on the QS World University Ranking. What makes our nursing really, really strong is actually the clinical practice part. We put a lot of focus in the real work experience and clinical practice. As a matter of fact, we have an exclusive relationship with Liverpool Hospital, which is one of the biggest hospital here. It is literally right next to our Liverpool campus, which is a campus that nursing students can choose to study as well. We do offer nursing degree in this Liverpool campus. Then the Liverpool Hospital is right next to the campus over there. Now we have an exclusive partnership with Liverpool Hospital to take on our nursing student to do their clinical practice in Liverpool Hospital alone. If you manage to visit Liverpool Hospital, one of the level of the hospital, when you go in, you will see Western Sydney logo plastered across the whole floor because the whole entire floor in the hospital is dedicated just to our student for their clinical practice. So that's something that's pretty cool. So there are two types. We have a Bachelor of Nursing graduate entry, it's a fast track 2 years degree. This is available only for students who already has a degree or higher in biological science, health, behavioral, or in nursing from back home. Or if you have already completed a 3 year post-secondary qualification and is a registered nurse in your home country. So then for the student who has satisfied this condition, then you can apply for a fast track 2 years Bachelor of Nursing. Other than that, if you don't have either of that, then you can apply to the full 3 years Bachelor of Nursing. So all you need is to have a successful completion of an Australian Year 12 equivalent with a minimum ATAR of 70. So after we convert that, for Vietnam, you're looking at Year 12 GPA 8 out of 10 for selected high school and 8.5 out of 10 for normal high school. Most importantly for nursing is the IELTS. No matter which university you go to, if you're looking to get an accredited nursing degree, you must have a minimum IELTS 7.0, no less than 7. Unfortunately, this is set by APRA, which is the nursing board in Australia, not by the university. So that's why it's quite strict. We understand it's high, it's challenging. And unfortunately, with the condition, we are not able to package any English or waive English. Again, these are all set by APRA, and if we want our student to be able to graduate and register to be a nurse here, we need to comply with what APRA requirement is, which is the English. So that's one of the thing with the nursing. If you have any other more specific question you'd like to ask about nursing, we can leave it to the end of the Q&A session. But generally, that's it. Media. So our media is also accredited by the Media Federation of Australia and the Public Relations Institute of Australia. We actually have a 2 million purpose-built media studio and industry-recognized television production unit in the main Parramatta campus. So we have a world-class facility for students who takes media. I think you can see some in the video earlier as well, this showcase. And these are some of our key partners for our media programs. So for media, you can choose to do the Bachelor of Communication for 3 years. And there are four different majors you can choose from: advertising, journalism, media arts production, or public relations. Or you can go for the Bachelor of Screen Media. It's 3 years, and So for Bachelor of Screen Media, unfortunately, we only have one intake a year, which is March every year. But for Bachelor of Communication, we are offering this coming July intake and also next year March intake as well. Well, you out there who are considering a postgraduate degree, then Master of Creative Industry, which is 2 years. So just a bit of, so you guys understand the entry requirement. It's for the all of the business program, including marketing and all of this media program, you just need to have completed a senior secondary high school graduation diploma with an average grade of 7.5 from selected above high school or 8.0 from all other high school. That's for offshore Vietnam. For onshore, you just need to successfully completed an Australian year 12 with ATAR 60 and the IELTS, they're all standard IELTS, so standard 6.5, no band less than 6. So this admission requirement you see here, it applies to all standard programs. So all of the communication, all of the marketing, all of the business, only except nursing. Nursing, that's a higher standard of admission requirement. Scholarships. We have two types of scholarships. So $5,000 or $7,500 per year. So it's a multi-year scholarship, not one-off. So you get that once every year for 3 years. If you have an HR 65 and equivalent, then you get the $5,000 per year. And if you achieve higher 75 HR or equivalent, then you get $7,500. And if you're applying for a postgraduate degree or undergrad using another undergraduate qualification, so if you have completed a bachelor or diploma here or back in Vietnam, then you will be based on this cutoff. So GPA of 4.55 out of 7 or 65% average, you get $5,000 per year, or 5.25, 75% if you achieve that, then you get $7,500 per year. So as you can tell, it's quite achievable. It's not hard at all. And you don't need to apply separately for scholarship. All scholarships are automatically assessed when you put in your application. So you don't need to put any special application. You don't need to write an essay or statement, anything like that. And this is a 50% vice chancellor scholarship. It's for very high achieving students with a GPA of 6.5 out of 7. So that's it from my part, everyone. Thanks for listening. Really appreciate your time. And as I say, if you have any question, we can chat about that later on.
Thank you so much, Ginny, for bringing out a lot of information from Western Sydney University. So just allow a few minutes for me to summarize and translate some key points from Western Sydney University. Okay. Thì để sau cái phần trình bày của cô Ginny thì chị muốn tóm tắt một số các cái ý chính về trường Western Sydney để các bạn dễ nhớ ha. Thì năm 2020 thì trường Western Sydney đã được vinh dự được xếp hạng là top 3 trên thế giới, các trường đại học trên thế giới theo Time Higher Education Ranking. Thì hiện tại thì Western Sydney có tổng cộng là 11 campus. Trong đó campus chính của họ là ở Parramatta. Thì trong cái do cái ảnh hưởng của cái dịch COVID-19 cho nên là trong tháng các cái kỳ nhập học trong năm 2020, đặc biệt là tháng 7, thì trường đã chuyển đổi hoàn toàn sang hình thức học online. Và trường cũng có một số các cái ưu đãi để mà hỗ trợ cho cái việc chuyển đổi này. Thì ví dụ như là đối với những bạn mà đang không ở Úc mà có cái kế hoạch du học trong năm 2020 thì các bạn có thể học đăng ký chương trình học online để có thể theo học chương trình của Western Sydney khi đang ở Việt Nam. Cho đến khi mà border mở cửa thì các bạn có thể sang Úc để mà tiếp tục chương trình học của mình như bình thường. Thì khi mà học online như vậy thì học phí hiện tại trường có hỗ trợ giảm 10% học phí cho các bạn. Và các bạn có thể đăng ký học ít môn lại. Hiện tại thì các bạn có thể đăng ký học 2 môn thay vì là 4 môn như bình thường để mà giảm tải cái khối lượng học tập của mình. Và khi mà các bạn học như vậy á, trong trường hợp các bạn không cảm thấy phù hợp với việc hình thức học online hoặc là kết quả visa của bạn có trục trặc thì các bạn có thể là nhà trường sẽ cân nhắc việc là hoàn phí lại hoàn toàn cho các bạn. Và khi mà học online như vậy, lỡ trường hợp mà các bạn có bị rớt môn thì nhà trường họ cũng sẽ tạo điều kiện cho các bạn học lại hoàn toàn free. Tuy nhiên là có điều kiện để mà họ xem xét. và những môn học mà bị fail thì sẽ không có thể hiện trên bảng điểm của các bạn về sau. Thì đây là một trong những cái hỗ trợ rất là lớn từ phía bên trường. Thì về cái phần mà thay đổi cho tạo điều kiện thuận lợi trong việc xét hồ sơ, thì nhà trường họ cũng gia hạn cái thời gian công nhận các cái chứng chỉ tiếng Anh, ví dụ như là những cái chứng chỉ IELTS hay là BTE hay TOEFL, thì hiện tại thời gian hiệu lực là họ kéo dài lên là 3 năm thay vì là 2 năm như bình thường. Và những cái chứng chỉ tiếng Anh khác cũng có thể được cân nhắc để mà xét nhập học vào trường, ví dụ như là IELTS Indicator, TOEFL Home Edition và Duolingo. Và những bạn mà chưa có cái điểm final hoặc là chưa có cái bằng tốt nghiệp thì các bạn cũng có thể nộp hồ sơ xét trước với điểm Predicted Score, và những cái kết quả học tập các bạn có thể là bản chụp hình hoặc scan để mà trường xét trước. Và cái bản official, cái bản chính thức, kết quả chính thức các bạn có thể bổ sung cho trường trước một tuần so với cái ngày nhập học là được. Thì về chương trình của trường á, thì hiện cái về khoa business thì hiện tại trường có ba cái chương trình gọi là top program của họ. Thứ nhất là chương trình Bachelor Business trong 3 năm. Thì trong cái Bachelor Business này có rất là nhiều các cái chuyên ngành. Thì khi các bạn đăng ký Bachelor Business của trường thì các bạn có thể chọn tối đa là 2 chuyên ngành để mà học trong cái bằng Bachelor này. Chương trình thứ hai là chương trình Master of Business Administration 2 năm. Và chương trình thứ ba là Master of Marketing. Chương trình Master of Marketing thì các bạn có thể đăng ký học 1 năm, 1 năm rưỡi hoặc là 2 năm. Thì trong trường hợp mà những bạn mà có cái kế hoạch muốn hoàn tất nhanh khóa học thì các bạn có thể chọn cái khóa học ngắn với thời gian ngắn 1 năm, 1 năm rưỡi. Còn những bạn mà muốn có cái cơ hội để mà xin tiếp cái visa làm việc ở lại sau khi tốt nghiệp thì các bạn có thể chọn cái chương trình MBA Master 2 năm ha. Về nursing của trường, chuyên ngành y tá của trường thì là các bạn yên tâm là chương trình y tá của trường là được công nhận bởi Hiệp hội Y tá và Hộ sinh của Úc luôn. Cho nên là sau khi các bạn tốt nghiệp thì các bạn đáp ứng đủ điều kiện về bằng cấp để mà có thể đăng ký trở thành một y tá chuyên nghiệp ở Úc. Thì hiện tại Western Sydney xếp hạng number one các trường dạy nursing ở Úc bởi Center for World University Ranking. Hiện tại thì trường nằm ở top 100 trên thế giới theo QS Ranking. Thì chương trình Bachelor of Nursing của trường á, có hai chương trình là chương trình Bachelor of Nursing Graduate Entry là 2 năm. Chương trình này dành cho những bạn mà đã từng học qua hoặc là có kinh nghiệm liên quan tới lĩnh vực y tá thì các bạn có thể học và tốt nghiệp nhanh trong sau 2 năm. Riêng với những bạn mà chưa có kinh nghiệm thì các bạn cũng đừng quá lo lắng, bởi vì trường họ có cái chương trình Bachelor of Nursing 3 năm. Thì chương trình này chủ yếu là phù hợp cho các bạn high school. Thì các bạn chỉ cần là tốt nghiệp lớp 12 với điểm, nếu mà ở Việt Nam thì các bạn chỉ cần điểm GPA là 8 trên 10 từ những trường chuyên. Và nếu mà trường high school bình thường thì các bạn cần đạt là 8.5 trên 10 để mà có thể xin vô chương trình Bachelor of Nursing. Yêu cầu tiếng Anh của chương trình nursing của trường là hiện tại là IELTS 7 chấm overall và không có kỹ năng nào dưới 7 chấm. Về chương trình media thì hiện tại bên trường Western Sydney, chương trình media của họ có Bachelor of Communication 3 năm. Trong đó các bạn cũng có thể chọn nhiều các cái major ở trong đó, ví dụ như học về advertising, journalism hoặc là public relation thì các bạn có thể chọn chuyên ngành cho mình. Chương trình thứ hai đó là Bachelor of Screen Media 3 năm và một chương trình sau đại học là Master of Creative Industry thì chương trình này là 2 năm. Thì yêu cầu của chương trình này thì cũng là theo yêu cầu chuẩn là IELTS là 6.5, không kỹ năng nào dưới 6. Và các bạn hoàn tất lớp 12 ở Úc với điểm ATAR khoảng độ 60 hoặc là tương đương thì các bạn cũng có thể là đăng ký vào thẳng chương trình này rồi. Về phần học bổng thì hiện tại bên Western Sydney có rất là nhiều các cái chương trình học bổng. Thì ấn tượng là chương trình học bổng Vice Chancellor Excellence Scholarship thì học bổng này trị giá lên tới 50% học phí cho dành cho cả bậc đại học và sau đại học luôn. Và học bổng này sẽ được trả xuyên suốt trong suốt thời gian các bạn học tại trường. Học bổng thứ hai đó là học bổng dành cho các bạn học chương trình đại học. Thì là học bổng này sẽ là trị giá từ 5.000 cho tới 7.500. Và các bạn học chương trình sau đại học cũng có thể apply cái học bổng này luôn. Thì học bổng này gọi là Western Sydney International Undergraduate Scholarship và International Postgraduate Scholarship. Và thì học bổng này thì mỗi học bổng sẽ có những cái yêu cầu đầu vào xét tuyển khác nhau, cho nên là nếu hiện tại các bạn vẫn còn đang phân vân không biết là mình phù hợp với học bổng nào thì các bạn có thể liên hệ với du học sát để mà được tư vấn cụ thể cũng như hỗ trợ các bạn trong việc apply các bạn ha. Okay, so và bây giờ sẽ là đến phần chia sẻ thông tin của trường Đại học Nam Úc. And now we are coming to the information session of University of South Australia. Miss Mindy is sharing us the information about Faculty of Health Science, which is one of the most popular and attractive study major to students. Yes, so please, Mindy.
Thank you, everyone. I hope everyone's still awake, like me. Can you see my screen well?
Yeah.
Good, thank you. All right, I'll try to keep it short and fun in a way. So welcome to University of South Australia. As you can see, it's pretty cold here. Vietnam is beautiful. I hope I can go there. Usually I travel to Vietnam like 2 to 3 times a year. Hopefully the border will be open soon. So in Adelaide, we're looking forward to the our border is gonna be open on the 20th July for interstate travel. So soon maybe we can open for the whole Australia border, fingers crossed. All right, so Janice was introducing you about Western Sydney. So please switch your mind to South Australia now. So we fly from Sydney to Adelaide, which only takes about 2 hours domestic flight. And in South Australia, as you can see, Adelaide is the capital city. So in our city, that you got lots of opportunities that you can have a big engagement with our partners in different industry. And in the city, we have 2 main campuses and there are another 2 around the city. So the distance give you a mindset, it's about like in Ho Chi Minh City from District 1 to District 5. So it's not very far. And the whole public transportation is quite well designed in the city. So on the map, you can see it's very well designed. I don't think you will get lost. I would, because I'm not very good at direction. But it's a very well designed and it's surrounded by the parkland. So within the city, from number 1 to number 2, which is our City West campus to City East campus, there is a free train. So you can hop on the train, it's free. But I totally encourage you can just have a good walk in the city. It only takes about 10 to 15 minutes and it's very comfortable walking on the street in Adelaide. So our nursing program is situated in number 2 Campus East campus. And then it's right next to the shopping mall. So if you like shopping, best location for you as well. And in numbers, between number 6 and 7 is where our main accommodation. So it's very close to both campuses, which benefit our students who don't have a car and can easily to travel around in the city. So you pay, this is your investment for your future. You you choose to come to Australia to study. Why? Because you want to graduate and then you want to get a good job. And of course, you want to get a good pay. That's everyone's goal. And but how are you going to succeed with a limited budget that you have from your parents? One, you pay a lot of money for towards your tuition fees, but actually you would need to put the money aside for your rent. Because in Australia, living costs that you pay a lot towards to the rent, but I think in Adelaide is a good start for you as international student because it's much lower living of cost in compared to other bigger cities. So it's approximately between 13% to 16% less to live in Adelaide compared to the Sydney and Melbourne. And other than that, it's an affordable city and it's very safe as well. And so you save a lot of money on your rent. And we also in South Australia, we provide concession to international students for public transportation. And like I mentioned, within the city, there is free train, but outside of city, you get concession. So you pay about only, this is actually $50 for 28 days is unlimited pass on three different public transportations. But if you only travel once daily within city or out, it only probably costs you $5. $5 to $10 within a day. So it's a really, really good advantage for you as international student to choose to pursue your international degree and with less costs. So now to University of Australia, South Australia, our quick overview about us. So we have approximately total student number, we have about 31,000 students above, and about 20% is international students from over 80 different countries. So which would benefit you to meet not just maybe your met friends from your home country, but you also make a lot of friends from different countries. I think this is one of the advantages to come to Australia to study. Because I was an international student and I made a lot of friends from different backgrounds, and we now all become everyone is in different professional industry and very successful, and you help each other down the road during your journey. So this would open the door for your future career and personal support as well. So we offer over 200 degrees, and we're currently sitting at top 50 under 50 years old from the QS and Time Higher Education World University Rankings. So we are young universities, but we're quite very proud to say we have achieved a lot internationally and nationally. We recently just went through a reform. So strategically, we have now become from four faculties, become seven different academic units. So this way we actually have less layers. So we wanna make sure we can get projects, get research, get our new programs, and also to have more innovative development success to be successful in different areas. So we wanna make it happen. So we make the layers less. So this is, we're looking forward to it. And so you'll see the first one is our aligned health and human performance. And each faculty has its strengths, but this is not limited to what I shown on the slides. So in this academic unit, we are very proud to say that we offer exercise sports science, which is now in top 100 in the world. And in addition to that, we also provide a lot of training and programs to nurture our students to become professionals in the rehab industry. And we also offer business courses. As you can see from the screen, we have the ACORS accreditation, which is, not all the universities in Australia has this accreditation. And in business school, that I would say they are really strong to provide the mentorships and internships to our students throughout their study. So I think one of the questions from the chat room that I noticed is one of the students was asking, oh, how can they guarantee their future graduate outcomes in marketing? I think it's very important that during your study, you have this opportunity to be able to engage with the industry partner. So UniSA will provide the opportunity and the mentorship to our students to make sure they are job ready before they graduate. And the third one is our clinical health sciences, where we offer our nursing and midwifery and also lab battery medicine and pharmaceutical science and pharmacy. So nursing is sitting at top 100 in the world at the moment. And also pharmacy and pharmacology is actually ranked top 150 in the world. We also offer creative related programs, and one of the, I wanna highlight our architecture is one of the oldest schools in Australia, where our students, they are able to involve in very big projects nationally and internationally. And we recently just reformed, so we have a creative arts industry related programs and trainings in this field. And our media, film, and TV is quite famous in this industry because one of our graduate alumni, he owned a company called Rising Sun Picture, where he hired our graduates to work as artificial effects. So it's like a movie industry. So if you are really into movies, please come to UniSA. And then education and futures, we got very, very proud to say a top 10 in Australia for developing work-ready skills in this field as well. So our teaching is quite good for their teaching quality and graduate outcomes as well. And the law degree is sitting at top 100 in the world. And UniSA engineering and IT, it also offers very, very skill and industry required programs, such as aviation, engineering, and IT cybersecurity, etc. I'm sorry, I had to be fast because I think we are running out of time. And so latest results that we received, that we are very happy to see that the positive outcomes we have. So we have quite good feedback for our student satisfaction and our graduate skills in health services. All right, I like pictures. So you can see lots of my slides is with images. And so Adelaide City is also a biomed city. So you can easily to see. So like I said, that this is from the part of, if you can recall the map that I show, this is from the City West Campus, which is right located here on the right-hand side corner. And then you'll see our research, Cancer Research Institute is right next to it. And then also, because I think for the for the education that is very important, that the support from the government. So we have a very big support and we have very strong relationships with our state government as well. So they have founded South Australia Health and Medical Research Institute, and recently they just opened the second building right next to it. And then right next to the Research Institute is the Royal Adelaide Hospital. So this is used to be right near our city east campus, but now it's moved because it's expanded. So they moved the whole hospital to the west side of the city. And this is one of the largest teaching hospital in Southern Hemisphere. So a lot of our students in health sciences, including nursing and midwifery students, they would undertake their placement here. So like I say, it's so close to our campus. So really, really benefit our students in terms of commuting, and they can just go to the class in the morning, or now it's online class, but then they go to the placement in the afternoon. So I just mentioned that the strong network we have with the industry is not only with our placement providers. We have over 500 clinical placement providers, and we also have strong engagement and relationships with the government, which will create lots of job opportunities to our graduates. All right. So here are our programs, or you call courses, that we offer at UniSA related to health. But today I'm gonna emphasize nursing. So I'll give a more detailed information to share with you. So Bachelor of Nursing at UniSA, sitting at top 100 in the world, and SAM is accredited by the Australian Nursing and Midwifery Accreditation Council. So some of you that you're thinking, oh, I think I wanna become a nurse, I wanna study nursing. So ask yourself these questions. Are you caring? Do you like to work with people? Do you have good communication skills? If you don't have at the moment, it's fine, because this is what sort of trainings and skills you will have, and then you will achieve after you study with us at UniSA. So I think in Australia, it's very important to have good communication skills. And it's not just communicating, it's about how do you communicate with people from different countries, because Australia is a very diverse background countries. And but you will get that during your study and training at UniSA. It's a 3-year degree. However, if you have a similar, so if you already have some training in your home country, we can assess case by case, and then you might receive a less study period with us. And we accept students every February each year. So the next intake will be 2021. I think the high school GPA we require from Vietnam is 7.5. So some of our students now online, you are probably in different states. So what we require is ATAR 67. So when you put in your USA Tech application, you put UniSA nursing as your first preference, then we'll go from there. So Sam, IELTS 7, same as Denise just mentioned, it's actually required by the Accreditation Council. So if you didn't meet our entry requirement, 7.5 GPA, don't panic. That we have a password provider called SAIBT, S-A-I-B-T. They located right on our campus, all right? So you can we'll give you a package offer, come to study 1 year or I think 10 months, diploma degree, then you can join us at UniSA. Oh, sorry, I go back. So our degree that provide you lots of clinical placements. On our first year, I think one of the advantage and strengths of our nursing degree is we provide clinical placement. Our student has to go to clinical placement from the second semester of their first year. But don't panic, say, oh, I'm not ready. Don't worry, we'll make sure you're ready before we place you in a placement. And all the placements are guaranteed and are arranged by us, so students don't need to panic. So as you can see, all the courses I highlighted in red, these are clinical placements. So all the way from first year to your final year. We have a simulated hospital right on our campus. So it's owned by UDSA. So you will be trained here before we place you to your first placement. So you will do at least 170 hours of practice in our Horizon Hospital. I will play a short video of our Horizon Hospital so then you will have a good idea what sort of facilities that we have here. All right. Sorry. By now you probably wanna do choose our nursing now, I hope. All right, so before you go to your first clinical placement, what do you need to prepare? That you don't need to panic because during your orientation, our teachers, they are really friendly, approachable, and they will come to you, hold your hand, say, oh, you have to get these documents ready before you can go on to a placement. So these are the three essential documents you need to prepare. You don't need to do it before you come to Australia, you do it after, okay? So, and the first two documentation, you just do it online. You just put in an online application and then it's through a third party. And once you get it, you'll be fine. It doesn't take long. And I've got a student very, very proactive from Malaysia. And he emailed me and said, oh, I have gone to the police station in Malaysia. I get my criminal check. Please don't do that. Don't go to the police station to get criminal check. Everything is online now. It's all digital. And then the third one is the immunization. So this is make sure that you have the vaccination ready in your body that is required by in Australia. But if you're not sure what you have, it's fine. Just come here. After you come here, you just need to go to do a blood test. And then they can tell from the blood test what you have or you don't have. All right, so after you've got your documents ready, you're ready to go to your first placement. So you will then expect to do at least 1,000 hours of clinical placements in our study, all right? In your degree. So first year you'll do 40 hours placement. Second year you'll do at least 8 weeks placement. And the third year you can do 16 weeks placement. And during your study here, a lot of questions I get is, oh, can I go and do some part-time work with any sorts of providers? And yes, you can. Just make sure that it's legal, all right? And make sure that what's your entitlement from your student visa as well. So you successfully graduate from UniSA, get your degree, then you can then prepare to apply for your registration with Nursing and Midwifery Board. So this is two different body, all right? Janice and I mentioned is the Australian Accreditation Body, and this one is the Nursing and Midwifery Board of Australia. So if you wanna become a registered nurse in Australia, you have to register with them. And they would require an IELTS 7 or equivalency test. So therefore you need to undertake that again, right, to prove that your English level is the IELTS 7 equivalent. It's required by the Nursing and Midwifery Board. So career opportunities. So I think from our mindset, we always think nurses can only work in the hospitals. They have to work weird hours. They need to work night shifts. Yes, maybe in the beginning at a junior level, but then once you progress into different, you gain different skills, and also depends on your interest and what are you more passionate about. So some of you might say, oh, after you are exposed to different trainings and clinical places, then you might say, okay, I'd like to work with kids. Then you might go to the children's hospital, or maybe you will go to schools. So there are many, many different opportunities for you to choose from as a nurse, all right? So one of my students, she likes fast pacing environment, because she's originally from Hong Kong. No offense, but not because everyone from Hong Kong likes the high pressure work environment, but she loves it. So she chose to work in ER, emergency room, and then she got selected to, as a professional team to go to Dubai for 2 years. Now she just recently returned to, last year she returned to Australia. So lots of opportunities for you, not just in Australia, also globally. Okay, lots of inquiries and confusion about what type of nurses we have in Australia. So from the screen, very, very clear, there are three types. So one is a nurse practitioner, which will require higher training and higher education level to be able to become a nurse practitioner in Australia. And lots of our students, once they graduate, of course, they become a registered nurse. So registered nurse, they can supervise enrolled nurses. Enrolled nurses, which means enrolled nurses, they would need to supervise by an RN or indirect to be supervised by them. And the salary scale is different as well. And educational qualification is different as well. So, salary. SA, South Australia, so you can see our salary package is quite, I think, above average. And if we take out the registered nurse and midwife, then the entry level, it actually increases every year and depends where you will be working. So the salary package will be different. So, but the maximum, I think it's higher than 80,000, because really one of my friends, she is a nurse director. It's much higher than that because they have more responsibility. So you can see that you get a degree, you pay less for your cost of living in South Australia, but you get a pretty good wage as your outcome. This is your investment. So I take the level out. There are different levels from level 1, 2, 3. All right. So like I mentioned, it really depends on what sort of service and what sort of responsibility that you are taking to decide your salary package. But overall, the entry level is much higher than my first job in Australia. The future, our future of nursing. So this is just the latest article that I have read. So last week, they just predicted that the demand for qualified nurses in Australia is actually expecting more than 120,000 by 2030. And I think it will be more because of the pandemic. And in which area? So we do need lots of nurses in aged care, mental health, and clinical nursing. So like I say, job opportunities a lot, but you got to make sure you are prepared before the job opportunity falls on you. Scholarship. We offer two types of scholarship. The first one is international scholarships. So it would offer you, offer you 25% discount for your first year study at UniSA. But this doesn't, this is for students who start from first year in UniSA, right? And for high achieving students, then we offer a 50% discount for your whole study, 3 to 4 years at UniSA. Sorry, I think my slides is not in the order. That's all from me. And then I think we can have a further discussions for in our Q&A session.
Thank you so much, Mindy. Yeah, so just some minutes to summarize the key points and in Vietnamese. Thì sau phần trình bày của cô Mindy thì chị sẽ tóm tắt một số các cái ý chính đến từ thông tin đến từ trường Đại học Nam Úc. Thì Đại học Nam Úc là nằm hiện tại là nằm trong top 50 trường đại học trẻ tuổi ở trên thế giới. Thì tiểu bang Nam Úc là một nơi thực sự theo như chia sẻ của cô Mindy là một nơi có môi trường học tập rất là tốt với chi phí sinh hoạt rất là vừa phải so với các cái thành phố lớn. Ví dụ như là riêng về việc sử dụng phương tiện công cộng thì nếu mà các bạn sử dụng phương tiện công cộng ở khu vực trung tâm thành phố thì hoàn toàn miễn phí. Còn nếu mà ngoài khu vực city thì các bạn còn được trợ giá cho chi phí đi lại nữa. Thì trong bên phía trường Đại học Nam Úc có rất là nhiều phân khoa. Thì hôm nay cô Mindy của tập trung chia sẻ về khoa Health Science là những ngành liên quan tới khoa học sức khỏe. Thì khoa Health Science ở trường Đại học Nam Úc có rất giảng dạy rất là nhiều chuyên ngành. Trong đó là đơn cử là y tá, hồi sinh, hoặc là khoa phục hồi chức năng, hoặc là ngành dinh dưỡng, quản lý các cái dịch vụ y tế công cũng được giảng dạy trong khoa này luôn. Thì riêng về chương trình y tá, thì chương trình y tá của Đại học Nam Úc hiện tại là xếp hạng 100 trên thế giới theo QS Ranking năm 2019. Và bằng cấp của Đại học Nam Úc cũng tương tự như Đại học Western Sydney là sẽ được công nhận bởi Hiệp hội Y tá và Hộ sinh của Úc luôn. Thì các bạn cũng sẽ phân vân không biết là mình có phù hợp với ngành nghề y tá này không, đặc biệt là các bạn trong độ tuổi high school. Thì cô Mindy cổ cũng có chia sẻ là các bạn sẽ xem thử là mình có có đa số hoặc là có tất cả những cái đặc điểm về tính cách như sau. Ví dụ như là các bạn có cái kỹ năng phân tích, đưa ra giải pháp hoặc là đưa ra quyết định một cách nhanh chóng hay không, giống như là phản xạ nhanh, và các bạn có muốn trị liệu cho những người mà cần có cái sự chăm sóc về y tế hay không nè. Rồi các bạn cũng cần có tính cách là thích quan tâm, cảm thông và chia sẻ để mà các bạn có thể là giao tiếp với bệnh nhân, chia sẻ với bệnh nhân của mình. Và kỹ năng giao tiếp tốt cũng là một cái cần để mà các bạn học tập trong cái ngành nghề này. Thì nếu mà các bạn hiện tại các bạn đang thích mà các bạn cũng thấy là mình cũng chưa có hội đủ những cái yếu tố này, thì theo như cô Mindy nói thì các bạn cũng đừng có quá lo lắng, tại vì trong cái quá trình các bạn học ở trường thì các kỹ năng này sẽ được phía trường hỗ trợ để mà cải thiện trong suốt cái quá trình các bạn đi học đó, để mà đạt và cả trong quá trình thực tập nữa, thì để các bạn có thể tự tin ra khi các bạn đi làm thêm hoặc các bạn tìm kiếm công việc sau tốt nghiệp. Thì chương trình y tá của trường Đại học Nam Úc là chương trình giảng dạy 3 năm. Thì Đại học Nam Úc, với chương trình này Đại học Nam Úc chỉ có một kỳ nhập học duy nhất là vào tháng 2 thôi. Và yêu cầu đầu vào cụ thể cho sinh viên Việt Nam mình là nếu mà các bạn đang ở Úc thì thông thường trường sẽ yêu cầu điểm ATAR là 67. Các bạn học ở Việt Nam thì điểm trung bình lớp 12 khoảng độ chừng 7.5 là có thể đạt cái yêu cầu học thuật của trường rồi. Riêng về IELTS thì trường yêu cầu là tương tự như Western Sydney là overall các bạn phải đạt IELTS là 7.0. Các kỹ năng cũng không có kỹ năng nào dưới 7.0 luôn. Trong trường hợp là các bạn rất thích học y tá, tuy nhiên là với điểm số tiếng Anh cũng như là điểm số về mặt học thuật các bạn chưa đủ để mà có thể vào thẳng chương trình Bachelor of Nursing, thì các bạn cũng có thể đăng ký chương trình cao đẳng liên thông gọi là Diploma of Health Science của trường, chương trình 1 năm tại Học viện SAIBT. Thì Học viện SAIBT là nằm chung trụ sở của Đại học Nam Úc luôn, rất là thuận tiện cho các bạn để sau khi các bạn hoàn tất chương trình Diploma of Health Science này thì các bạn có thể tiếp tục học năm thứ 2 của chương trình Nursing của trường. Thì trong quá trình học ngành này đó thì các bạn ngành Nursing đó thì các bạn sẽ được trải nghiệm về cơ sở vật chất rất là hoành tráng, đặc biệt là môi trường học tập ở khu vực gọi là Horizon Hospital and Health Service. Thì nôm na là giống như là không gian của bệnh viện, mô phỏng của bệnh viện và hoặc là một cái cơ sở y tế thực tế luôn. Đó thì các bạn cần phải hoàn tất ít nhất là 170 giờ thực hành trong cái khu vực này trước khi mà các bạn tiến hành đi thực tập ở bên ngoài. Thì lúc nãy cô Mindy cũng có chia sẻ hình ảnh của cái khu vực này qua cái clip của cổ. Và cái chương trình thực tập, thực hành trong trường đó, thực tập bên ngoài thì sẽ được nhà trường bảo đảm là sẽ sắp xếp cho các bạn. Các bạn không lo lắng cho việc là mình sẽ phải tự đi tìm nơi thực tập. Thì từ cái năm chương trình thực tập sẽ kéo xuyên suốt, trong suốt 3 năm các bạn học luôn. Thì các bạn cần phải hoàn tất là một, tổng cộng là 1.000 giờ thực tập. Ví dụ đơn cử là trong năm thứ nhất các bạn sẽ thực tập là 40 giờ, năm thứ hai thì các bạn sẽ có 8 tuần và năm thứ ba thì các bạn sẽ có tới 16 tuần để đi thực tập, để mà giúp cho các bạn ngoài là trong cái học thực hành ở trường thì cái thực tập bên ngoài này cũng sẽ giúp cho các bạn có đầy đủ những cái kinh nghiệm cũng như là những cái phản ứng để có thể ra ngoài làm việc. Thì lúc nãy như chị có chia sẻ thì bằng cấp của trường Đại học Nam Úc là được công nhận bởi Hiệp hội Y tá và Hộ sinh của Úc luôn. Thì ngoài bằng cấp ra thì để mà có thể đăng ký hành nghề và được xét duyệt bởi Hiệp hội này thì các bạn cũng cần có IELTS là 7 chấm đều, là overall 7 chấm và các kỹ năng cũng không có kỹ năng nào dưới 7. Thì về cơ hội nghề nghiệp á, thì sau khi mà tốt nghiệp cái chương trình Bachelor of Nursing, các bạn có thể apply công việc ở rất là nhiều nơi. Ví dụ như các bạn có thể làm việc ở các cái bệnh viện công, bệnh viện tư, hoặc là các cái trung tâm sức khỏe cộng đồng, những nơi mà chăm sóc phục hồi chức năng, hoặc thậm chí là các bạn có thể làm việc ở bộ phận chăm sóc sức khỏe của trường học luôn. Thì cái mức lương của ngành này á, riêng ở Nam Úc thì nó sẽ dao động tùy vào cái công việc của các bạn, tùy vào cái bậc y tá hành nghề của các bạn, thì thông thường nó sẽ dao động khoảng độ tầm 60.000 cho tới gần 90.000 đô la Úc cho một năm. Và hiện tại là ba cái ngành nghề liên quan tới y tá mà đang rất là cần và xu hướng là sẽ thiếu hụt trong tương lai, thì bao gồm là thứ nhất là y tá để mà chăm sóc người lớn tuổi, gọi là aged care nursing, và y tá chăm sóc về sức khỏe về tâm lý là mental health nursing, và y tá ở các cái phòng khám là clinical nursing á. Thì theo dự đoán á, là đến năm 2030 thì cái lượng thiếu hụt nó sẽ lên đến hơn 120.000 y tá. Cho nên là qua đây các bạn có thể thấy là cái cơ hội và cái nhu cầu sau khi mà các bạn tốt nghiệp y tá ở Nam Úc rất là cao. Riêng về học bổng thì bên phía Đại học Nam Úc hiện tại đang có rất là nhiều chương trình học bổng, và chương trình học bổng ấn tượng đầu tiên mà cô chia sẻ đó là học bổng Vice Chancellor International Excellence Scholarship. Thì học bổng này nếu các bạn đạt được thì các bạn sẽ nhận được lên đến 50% học phí, và trong suốt thời gian các bạn học luôn. Ví dụ các bạn học chương trình 3 năm thì các bạn sẽ nhận được học bổng trong vòng 3 năm, hoặc là các bạn học 4 năm thì các bạn sẽ nhận được học bổng trong xuyên suốt 4 năm luôn. Học bổng thứ hai đó là học bổng International Merit Scholarship. Học bổng này là trị giá 25% cho học phí của năm đầu tiên. Và học bổng này, cả hai học bổng này đều sẽ được xét duyệt dựa trên kết quả học tập của các bạn. Thì với những cái phần chia sẻ, thông tin chia sẻ về trường, về ngành học của hai trường Western Sydney và Đại học Nam Úc, thì chị thấy là với những cái thế mạnh về có sẵn về cơ sở vật chất cũng như chương trình đào tạo đó, thì chị tin là các bạn sau khi tốt nghiệp hai trường này sẽ có nhiều các cái cơ hội nghề nghiệp trong tương lai. Và hơn nữa là thêm một cái thông tin nữa về lợi thế khi mà các bạn chọn đi du học ở Úc, đặc biệt là học ở những nơi được định nghĩa là vùng regional, thì các bạn sẽ được hưởng thêm nhiều cái ưu thế. Thì ở đây Đại học Western Sydney họ cũng có cái campus ở Hawkesbury, cũng ở vùng regional, và campus của trường Đại học UniSouth Australia là cũng ở vùng regional luôn. Thì khi mà các bạn học tập và tốt nghiệp từ những vùng regional đó và các bạn nộp cái hồ sơ xin visa việc làm ở lại, thì các bạn sẽ có cái cơ hội là xin gia hạn tiếp 2 năm sau cái working visa khi mà các bạn học tập từ bậc cử nhân hoặc là cao hơn, ví dụ là thạc sĩ hoặc là tiến sĩ nghiên cứu. Và cái hồ sơ xin visa làm việc của các bạn cũng sẽ được ưu tiên xử lý xin thị thực của riêng khu vực đó luôn. Và hơn nữa là cái danh sách những cái ngành nghề mà các bạn được nộp á, nó cũng sẽ đa dạng và nó nhiều ngành nghề hơn so với những thành phố khác. Thì chị nghĩ đây là một trong những cái lợi thế mà các bạn cũng nên cân nhắc khi mà lên cái kế hoạch du học cho mình. Riêng về phần học bổng thì hiện tại hai trường là đang có rất là nhiều các cái chương trình học bổng ấn tượng. Thì mỗi chương trình nó sẽ có một, mỗi cái học bổng nó cũng sẽ có cái yêu cầu xét tuyển khác nhau, cũng như là cái deadline nộp hồ sơ khác nhau. Thì nếu mà hiện tại các bạn vẫn còn băn khoăn về cái quy trình cũng như là không biết mình có phù hợp để nộp học bổng không, thì các bạn cứ liên hệ với du học xét để mà các anh chị tư vấn ở đây sẽ giúp các bạn xem hồ sơ của mình và sẽ hỗ trợ cho các bạn nộp hồ sơ xin học bổng khi mà hồ sơ của các bạn phù hợp. Thì phần tiếp theo đây thì chị sẽ chia sẻ cho các bạn biết về những hỗ trợ của du học xét dành cho các bạn học sinh trong suốt thời gian mà các bạn theo học tại Úc. Thì với 17 năm kinh nghiệm trong thì hiện du học xét là đã có 17 năm kinh nghiệm trong lĩnh vực tư vấn du học. Du học xét luôn là nơi được nhiều phụ huynh gửi gắm niềm tin. Hiện tại hệ thống của du học xét có tất cả là 6 văn phòng. Hiện tại du học xét có tất cả 6 văn phòng ở Úc và Việt Nam. Trong đó thì có 3 văn phòng ở Sài Gòn, Hà Nội, ba văn phòng ở Úc và là ở ba thành phố Sydney, Melbourne và Brisbane sẽ luôn luôn đồng hành và hỗ trợ các bạn trong suốt thời gian các bạn học tập tại Úc. Du học sếp cũng thường xuyên tổ chức những buổi hội thảo hướng nghiệp tại Việt Nam và tại Úc. Và khách mời là những đại diện đến từ trường, những diễn giả hướng nghiệp nổi tiếng cũng như là những chuyên gia đầu ngành có tầm ảnh hưởng trong xã hội. Ngoài ra, du học sếp còn hỗ trợ tìm kiếm việc làm, tư vấn định cư cho sinh viên sau khi tốt nghiệp. Du học sếp rất mong nhận được sự ủng hộ và tin tưởng từ quý phụ huynh cùng các bạn học sinh. Và hiện tại thì du học sếp cũng đang có một chương trình tặng gói hỗ trợ trị giá lên đến 2.070 đô la Úc dành cho các bạn học sinh đăng ký kỳ khóa nhập học mới trong năm 2020 và kỳ nhập học đầu tiên của năm 2021. Thì các bạn có thể liên hệ với du học sếp qua các kênh thông tin như là Facebook, hội du học sinh của sếp, hoặc là có thể gọi điện thoại, email đến du học sếp để mà biết thêm thông tin chi tiết về gói hỗ trợ này. Thì các cái contact của du học sếp sẽ được nhắn tin ở một chatbox thì các bạn có thể chụp lại, lưu lại để mà liên hệ về sau ha. Thì hiện tại bây giờ là sẽ là thời gian dành cho một hỏi đáp. Thì nếu các bạn có những cái thắc mắc nào thì vui lòng nhắn tin ở một chatbox để mà phía du học sếp và trường sẽ hỗ trợ giải đáp cho các bạn ngay trong buổi sáng hôm nay luôn. Hi Mindy and Ginny, now is the time for question and answer. So far we have received many questions for to you guys. So yeah, I will have to read the question and may have to translate your answer to student. But I'm sure that most of the students today is studying in Australia, so their English is very good to understand and follow the information that you give. Yeah. Okay.
So should I just go through the Q&A and just pick out the one that's asking Western Sydney and I just answer right here, yeah?
Sounds good.
Great. So I've got the first one here from Honda asking about for marketing students, how to get a right job after graduation in Australia, any tips? What I can advise definitely is, as I mentioned at Western Sydney, when you go through the Bachelor of Business in Marketing, you have the option to take a work placement unit. So I would suggest aim for that. But don't wait till last minute, maybe in your first semester or second, start speaking to the unit coordinator and say that I'm interested to take the internship subjects. What do I need to prepare? What I need to do? So you get proper advice from our career consultants at Western Sydney. And with our network, we can actually connect you with the right employer and network opportunities. We have resume writing preparation, interview preparation for all students. But the biggest tip I can give you is you need to go out there to seek for help. We have all the support there for you. We have the internship option there for you. With the internship comes with strong support from the university and industry connection, but you need to go out there and approach the uni coordinator. You need to go out there and seek help, because the university have all these tools and support, but if you don't go to them and say you need help, they don't know that you need help. So so definitely reach out. As long as you reach out and you take initiative, if let's just say the school said, oh, you need to pick this on your resume, this is how you prepare for an interview to get the right job, then you won't have a problem. And once you're able to secure a right part-time job or internship while you're studying, when you graduate, you're pretty much set because you already have relevant work experience. And for other students that may be unable to get a placement or have no experience throughout your study, when you're graduating, you want to get a job, don't worry and don't stress, because that's the reason why we have our Western Sydney careers there to support all of our graduates to get the right job as well. So I say start when you study and start as early as you can. Don't wait till last minute. So that's what I can give to you all. Okay, and second from Tantana, I have a question for both universities. After graduating Bachelor of Nursing, will the school have their own hospital or clinic to support or hire a student? As I mentioned, we do have a strong partnership with a few big hospitals, with Liverpool Hospitals and a few hospitals in Westmead Health Precinct. And all of our students are compulsory going through a clinical practice in the hospital itself. So that means you will definitely have the opportunities to work in a real hospital. So once you have those relevant work experience, and if you successfully graduated and being a registered nurse in Australia, I don't think it's hard for you to find a job after that. But again, we do have the support for graduates. If you need help to get placement into hospital, we have very strong connection. But no, the university don't own any hospital, but we have a very strong affiliation and partnership with them, which we can definitely help our students. Hope that helped answer your question. That one's for Union. So yeah, I'll leave it to Mindy. What traits needed for being a nurse and what I have to prepare in advance? I'm sure Mindy has covered that pretty clear just now in her presentation. I've got one. This student has been issued a COE of MBA intake in July. This is a great question. And considering to commence online overseas due to the Australian border being closed, they can't come in. So the question here is, will that affect you when you apply for your 485 after completing your master? Now, this is a $1 million question that everyone wants. Unfortunately, it is still sitting at our government. They need to announce what they're going to do with this. However, last we spoke to them, they will consider based on, they will have an exception special consideration for students who are affected by COVID, specifically in this situation, but they have not announced any confirmed policy or update changes. However, there's one thing that's really important, I think, that's very relevant to this question is that, and a lot of people are not aware of that, to be qualified for your 485 visa, you only need to physically be in Australia to study your course. So your course durations do need to be minimum 2 years, but as long as you physically are in Australia to complete this course, you only need 1.5 years. So that's, I think it was 15 months. You just need to, 15 or 16 months physically in Australia to complete your full course, you can qualify for that. So you don't need to physically be in Australia to complete a 2-year course for 2-year duration. Hopefully that makes sense. It is actually on the website. Maybe I can try to find a link later while Mindy answer a question. I can post it over there for you guys. You know what? And the borders looking like they will be opening up quite soon. And the great thing is Vietnam is one of the good countries, you know. If anything, I think that the government will consider Vietnam first, because you guys are very considered to be one of the safest country when it comes to COVID. So we're pretty confident that by next year, so the following intake, you guys probably will be able to come into Australia to study. So that means you only need 1 semester to study abroad, so you still have at least 1.5 year duration to physically be in Australia. And but even then, if things didn't get better and, you know, you had to study overseas offshore, maybe you can just put on hold on your course, defer till when the border opens up, then you come back in. But again, as long as you're here physically for 1.5 year, that's enough. Hope that helps. What else?
Questions about scholarship from student named Yang Do. If I have GPA of 8.8 from normal high school in Hanoi, in Vietnam,
Okay. So unfortunately, I failed to mention earlier, I apologize for that. Our scholarships unfortunately applies to all courses except for nursing. We don't offer any scholarship to our nursing degree because our nursing is the most popular course where every year it reach maximum quota. So it maximum places. So because of the popularity of that, the university are not able to offer scholarship for that course. But other than nursing, every single course, the scholarship apply. So you would have definitely, with your GPA 8.84 in normal high school, you can definitely meet the 7,500 scholarship each year for any other course. But unfortunately, again, for nursing, Western Sydney is not offering scholarship for the nursing.
Yeah, thank you.
So sorry.
Jenny, just a moment. I will translate some important information to the student Giang Đỗ about this scholarship. Bạn Giang ơi, với cái kết quả học tập của bạn á, thì thực sự rất là xuất sắc. Tuy nhiên là các cái chương trình học bổng hiện tại của Western Sydney, thì lúc nãy cô Jenny cổ chia sẻ thì có một cái điều đặc biệt đó là không dành cho chương trình Bachelor of Nursing, tại vì là hàng năm chương trình Bachelor of Nursing luôn là một trong những chương trình top, những chương trình hot của trường và nhận được rất là nhiều các cái hồ sơ nộp vào. Cho nên là hiện tại chương trình học bổng sẽ không có apply cho chương trình Nursing. Tuy nhiên là với cái kết quả học tập của bạn á, thì cô Jenny cũng có nói là khi mà nộp vào những cái ngành khác thì chắc chắn bạn sẽ được nhận được cái học bổng trị giá là 7.500 đô la Úc đó. Cho nên là bạn cũng có thể cân nhắc những cái ngành khác của trường ha. Okay, Jenny, we go with the another questions.
So one more about scholarship. With how many 50% VC scholarships do we have? We have 80 of that in a year. So split into 40 for postgraduate, 40 for undergrad. So that comes to about 10 to 15 for each semester. And the specific requirement, of course, if you just meet your ATAR 95 equivalent, let me open a document after translating that too. So for the 95 ATAR equivalent, if you're from the selected of schools in Vietnam, that's a GPA of 9. Or for all the other schools, it's 9.3 GPA. If you're wondering if your school is the gifted school or not, I am now attaching a document for you that has a list of which one is considered as the gifted school. And if it's not on the list, then it will be all other. I think it's in the chat now, everyone. So you can open up, there is a list. If your high school is in that list, then you'll be considered the selected or gifted school. So the requirement is a bit lower. Other than that, it's a bit higher. So for the Vice Chancellor Scholarship, it's 9 out of 10, GPA 9. For all others, it's 9.3. And if you're looking at the $5,000 scholarship, it's for $5,000 scholarship, it's 7.5 for gifted school, or 8 out of 10 for others. And that's for 5,000, and for 7.5, it's 8 GPA out of 10 for selected, and 8.5 out of 10 for non-selected. That's 7.5. Hopefully that's a bit clear.
Don't worry about the list of high school in Vietnam, that we can share the student the list. Yeah. We have,
okay, cool.
Yeah, we have the list of the high school that
was. Oh, you have already? Oh, okay, great.
Yeah, we will send to a student later. It's okay.
Perfect. Okay. I think. One more. I think for both Western Sydney and Uni SA. Yes, PT can be accepted as well for nursing. So you have to show an English test. There's IELTS equivalent, but not necessary IELTS. So you can show PTE, which is 65, or BEN for PTE, or TOEFL as well. I think those are the only questions for me. Over to you, Mindy.
Thank you.
Just some minutes for me to translate the answer of Jenny to the last student. Bạn Phan lúc nãy có hỏi về ngoài yêu cầu về IELTS thì trường có chấp nhận BTE hay không? Thì cả hai trường là đều là say yes ha. BTE nếu mà các bạn đạt điểm 65 overall thì các bạn sẽ được xét tương đương với IELTS 7 chấm theo yêu cầu của chương trình nursing. Với bạn lúc nãy có một bạn tên là một bạn hỏi về học bổng 50% đó thì nếu mà các bạn tốt nghiệp các high school ở Úc thì trường sẽ xét dựa theo ATAR của các bạn thì ATAR thông thường là sẽ đạt ở mức điểm là 95, ATAR 95. Còn nếu ở Việt Nam thì trường sẽ có cái list các trường gifted là trường chuyên và các trường phổ thông không chuyên thì thông thường là các bạn đạt được cái điểm khoảng độ tầm 9.3 cho năm lớp 12 thì các bạn có thể là nộp đơn xin cái học bổng 50% này. Thì các bạn để lại contact để mà du học sách có thể liên hệ ngay và gửi cho các bạn cái list những trường phổ thông cũng như là xem lại hồ sơ của bạn từ trường này thì cái khả năng nộp hồ sơ như thế nào thì du học sách sẽ hỗ trợ hoàn toàn miễn phí để mà các bạn apply ha. Yeah, Mindy, yeah.
Thank you.
You can.
Yeah. I agree whatever you say. All right.
There are lots of questions waiting for you as well. Yeah.
Back to PTE, I just want to mention the PTE requirement to be equivalent to IELTS 7 from UniSA is 65. So with no communicative score less than 65.
Yeah.
So same, is it similar? Is it same as Western Australia, right?
Yes.
Yeah, same.
I'll send you the link of all the English comparison, then it's easier for you to have a look. Just send it to on the chat room.
Yeah, the first question from a student named Rosie. Is there any requirement before the placement, for example, health check or CV or application? And will UniSouth Australia support international student apply placement? Where can student do the placement? I think the information have already included in your presentation. Yeah. Could you
please? I think Rosie is already gone. But I'll answer this question like him just mentioned. It was listed, the three essential documents listed on my slide. And then, so these are only three. You don't need to do any other like a health check and everything else. And roughly the time frame you're looking at about 6 weeks before your first clinical placement, and you need to get the documentation ready. This is why we schedule our first placement in the second semester of the first year study. I think the difference is if you are coming to UniSA and join us from second year, because some of the students, you might get credit transfer into our program. So that means you may start on the second semester of the first year or maybe the second year of our degree. Then, which means you don't have a lot of time to slowly prepare this documentation, but we make sure that you have everything ready before you can go to your first placement. All right, so this is guaranteed. And you don't need to organize or arrange the placement yourself. It's all done by us. We have a team called Clinical Placement Unit. So that's the huge team. What's their job? Their job is to arrange all our students' clinical placement, not just for nursing students, because across our two academic units, we have a lot of students that need to do clinical placements.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can you translate first?
Yep, I got information. I will transfer to the student later.
Thank you.
So with the next questions.
Okay. So the next question is, okay. So I heard that Hong Ha are asking, oh, is it really free public transportation? It's free. It's real. And there is a bus connector in Adelaide that we call it bus city connector. So it goes clockwise and anti-clockwise in the city, so, which is free. But Adelaide City is really accessible and walking distance everywhere. So I walk 5 minutes from city east campus to the mall, 5 minutes to the hospital, 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. I got short legs, so I need to walk longer. But for you, you're probably quicker. So it's very convenient and very low cost if you choose to come to Adelaide to study. All right, what trends needs, like Jeannie's already covered most of the points. I think other than the admission requirement, you really need to ask yourself, is this the job you want to do in the future? Because once you choose your degree, this is a three-year degree and also a long-term investment for your career. So ask yourself, are you going to be happy working in a hospital, in a community sector, and then talking to people every day? And are you able to manage the stress, because there are different sorts of stress as a nurse? But we will train you for that. But think about it, and if yes, you think that's the job for me, then go for it. Okay, do I need to get IELTS 7 for Bachelor of Nursing after finishing diploma course? Yes, you do. However, SABIT, our pathway provider, they already embedded a special English program to help diploma students to help them to get the IELTS 7 equivalency level. Okay. Yeah, I already answered this one, the placement and...
Questions for scholarship, Vice Chancellor International Excellence Scholarship from Miss...
Yes. Strelitz. Okay, what's the GPA requirement? So for the International Merit Scholarship, so for Bachelor, you will need at least 8.5 GPA. For Master Program, you need 6.5 for the International Merit Scholarship. For International Merit Scholarship, you don't have to put in a application. As soon as you apply to our program and you got accepted into our program, you meet the GPA for scholarship, then you automatically get a scholarship, all right? This Chancellor Scholarship is different. So this one is more competitive, have limited places. So if you meet the GPA 9, out of 10 for bachelor programs and 8.5 for master programs, then we will invite you to apply for Vice Chancellor Scholarship.
Yeah, so just application required for 50% scholarship, and for the 25% scholarship, yeah.
Only just apply for our course.
Yeah, clear, thank you.
Yeah. I think that's all right. Did I miss anyone's question?
I see you also sent a message that your answer to some student is good.
Yeah, I've already answered some questions. Any more questions? Everyone's so quiet.
So far, one question is answered now.
So there's no more question coming through in the next 10 seconds.
Thì hiện tại nếu không còn câu hỏi nào thêm thì chương trình hỏi đáp trực tuyến ngày hôm nay xin tạm dừng tại đây. Thì cảm ơn các bạn đã dành thời gian của buổi sáng cuối tuần để mà tham dự chương trình hỏi đáp. Thì nếu sau buổi ngày hôm nay mà các bạn có thêm những câu hỏi hay thắc mắc nào dành cho trường cũng như dành cho Du học Séc thì các bạn có thể liên hệ lại Du học Séc để mà được hỗ trợ thông tin nhé. I think no more questions will come to us. Thank you so much for your time and bringing us a lot of information from the university, from Western Sydney University and University of South Australia. Thank you so much, Janice and Mindy.
Thank you for organizing
this, us.
For having us.
Yeah.
And thanks everyone for your Saturday time. Appreciate it. Hope it was a great session to everyone.
Yeah, thank you. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.
Yeah, have a good one.
Bye-bye.